Hello everyone, this is Lefabre, and welcome to this Space 2 tutorial for the Awakening expansion. In this one, I explain you the new features related to the Academy in this expansion. My apologies because I have to rush a bit to have this tutorial ready for today. Just the release day, and I will release what I've got. So it's the English version of the first part of this tutorial, and I'm not sure if I'll have the Spanish and Catalan translations, but in any case, Spanish and Catalan will be available, I hope, tomorrow or just in 3 or 4 days. Sorry, guys, I've got a job and a family, like everyone. I hope for you. I'll be showing you the following parts of the tutorial today, what I can, and I hope tomorrow, or in any case, in the following days. But this is the new features about the Academy in this expansion. I'm playing, if you're just curious, the new faction, but the new faction will come in its own tutorial. What Amplitude made here was giving more importance to the Academy and to the Heretic is Yonder. Once everything will start, once you discover the Academy. The Academy is here, you can see this is very different from what you're used to in the previous expansions and on the base game. Here, Academy has one system that we can see. This is colored like any faction. Yes, the Academy is somewhat an unplayable. You cannot play the Academy faction. But they play like its own faction, so you'll have to deal with them. Here there are Academy ships. Academy ships has its own look. I think it's like a reskin of Vodiani. And they've got their systems. They will expand like a faction, and all new features will start at the turn you discover the Academy or anyone else discovers the Academy. Just to access these new features, we'll have to end the turn, and after this, all Academy new stuff will begin. Just end the turn. Whoa. It wasn't so slowly. Well, it's a hack, sorry. It's confirmation, no. And here's the new star. Once you find the Academy, the relationship with the Academy basically consists that Isiander will ask you for what he's in need of. In this case, he's asking for dust. All requests I've seen are dust, influence, or strategic resources. But it's somewhat randomly depending on what's available in the galaxy. He'll never ask for a resource that is not available in the galaxy. And well, I don't know the other conditions. Here you can see the other relationships of the Academy. And there will be a tutorial about the relations and reparations for Academy. But as I told you have to wait a bit. Also, if you look at this, notifications has somewhat a different color from Hero ones. Actually, start negotiations, and this is how it works. If you give things to Isiander, let's give some dust because he's asking for dust. Well, if you give what they ask for, every 20 turns you'll be rewarded with a role in the Academy. It's like you are in charge of some aspect of the Academy. There are four roles, I'll explain later. and the player that contributes the most gets the first role he or she picked. You can drag and drop the roles, or in, well, you see, the Grand Admiral, Master of the Librarian, assume you, I want to be the Librarian, I put it, this one here. If I, you are in the second place regarding contributions, then if the one who won the request phase didn't pick the same first role as you, you'll be rewarded the first role. So it's not, it's to say the one who contributes the most will get the role he was assigned on the left. The second one will get the role he prioritizes within the three remaining, and the third one within two remaining, and the fourth what remains. Well, this is yes, it's like an auction to understand it here. Then let me go for another save in this game, just a more advanced. It's just 20 turns and we'll see what all this is about. Just a save. And here you are again, less than a second after I told you. And what about what's saying the academy? Well, as you can see, there's only one turn left to end this auction. I'm in third place. So we will go back to this save game. I'll show you every role what can do. But here, as a little trick, this is not an explorer trick, but you can see my position here. If you want to call, the trouble is you only know. Well, the thing is, how much I have to give to his gender to get the role I want. Well, obviously I have to be the one giving most of the results. But how much is people giving, how many of the resources people giving to his gender? Well, you need a calculator, and then if it's in percentage, I give a 4%. And I don't know the total of the bar, but I know, here you can see, I give 105 dust. Then take our calculator and let's take 105 divide by 4 multiply by 100, and this is, okay, that's divide by this number and multiply by 100. If you are a mathematician or well, you are used to these things, sorry, because it will be very easy for you, but I think it's not the case of everyone playing the game. Let's multiply by this divide by this number and multiply by 100 this quantity you you given. Then this is you'll get the total of this bar. The total of this bar would give me it's 2625 dust. Well, assuming 2600 dust of total, I'll give here 1500 dust. The Academy. Yes. Well, and now it takes, I give easy under 1,600 dust, and I'm the first. I don't know why the bar is not updating. I'm sure at the moment of release this one will be fixed. And we will just end the turn, and I left here, you see how I can drag and drop the roles. I leave here Grand Admiral. A turn. And turn. And there is a notification from the Academy. The roles available for second men have been distributed as I see fit. But basically, he sees the one giving him more dust. That is how it fits. Please execute the host of fullest of your abilities. In order to encourage cooperation and trust, the leadership of the Academy may offer key roles to various leaders. Here I am, Lofabre, and I'm Grand Admiral now. Let's start negotiations. And here's the role. The others are great. Out. I know if I meet a player like those ones, I know who's get every role. This one is for the med player. The roles will last for other 20 turns. And after 20 turns, there will be another request from the Academy. So for total, it's 40 turns. 20 for the request and 20 when you get the role. Here, what I get is that they give me control over the Academy free for 20 turns. And here, slightly clicking here, I'll be shown where the fleet is. This fleet will always appear on your capital system. Here, there's this little icon. He offers you to rent the main ship of the role, and you can do whatever you want with the ship while during while you are in charge of the role. So during these 20 turns, at the end of these 20 turns, the ship will go. Select the system you wanted. Let's say Arcturus, and just pay for renting it. And we can see where this fleet is. Well, let's see the main fleet. Main fleet is here. And I'm in charge of this. As you can see, I'm in turn 47. Have in mind, in all my tutorials, I tailor some games for the tutorial, so don't expect some trick to beat this game in endless. Just it's tailored to show you the features. But as you can see in this turn, 70 command points fleet, well, it's awesome. Always the Academy fleet contains a carrier, plus well, you can inspect the other ships. And it's here, and well, I will control this fleet for 20 turns. Plus, the ship I've just hired, because well, I've got the role, it's a carrier. So, isn't bad. Well, let's see what happens if I pick another role. So I'll stop recording for some time to reload, but it will be just less than a second for you. Let's go. Well, I think it was only 1 second for you. But you can see the situation. I just reloaded the game, but pick another role. This time I pick Master of Dust. And I did the same trick to calculate how much it has to be. Well, what's Master of Dust? Let's go to the Academy. This is Master of Dust. Here, I can hire, I can rent the ship for being Master of Dust again. This is the same mechanic as before. And, well, you can see this is a carrier. This is always good ship. Basically, what Master of Dust does is that Isiander give me access to the Academy account, so whatever you can call it. And he gives me 2,800 dust for grants, basically for diplomacy. Let's they put here a short term. Well, basically this, you can spend this dust. This is not a fixed value, it will change every time you get the roll. And he gives you dust for diplomacy. Well, let's go to diplomacy. Imagine I want to pay these funds. Well, I don't know, I want to buy some resource for them or whatever. This icon. Here you can see this is dust, and this is the Academy icon with dust here in blue. This is Academy grant. I can give them how much dust I want to. Let's see, give them 1,000 dust and ask for elements. Well, they don't want to. They don't want 100 dust for one element, I'm not sure. one transplant, what? Sorry about. But well, just give them the dust.
Gosh, we are so surprised that you're.
The thing is that this dust, I won't pay anything because Academy is paying for me. So it's Master of Dust. It's like free dust for diplomacy. Sorry about the speaking of dust. I didn't tell you, but Grand Admiral Fleet hasn't got any upkeep. So it's to a free fleet. Now let's go for another role. I will repeat again same operation just a second for you. Here we go again. Repeated the same, but this time you can see low fabric keep. I picked bolt keeper. Sorry, you can here I'm not a born English speaker. So, but you can see here in Academy screen bolt keeper and the other great out. Here you can run the ship again. This is again a carrier. Those are awesome skins. And what Bolt Keeper allows you is to access the knowledge of the Academy and pick a party. Well, let's go to say we'll pick ecologists. Those are ecologist louts. Select ecologist party. And let's go to our Senate screen. Our leading political parties are pacifists and scientists. But if I want to pass a law, I pick ecologist. What it allows me is to pass any law of the party I've just picked, except the default law. Well, having the default law will be somewhat overpowered. So I can pick the pacifist, the scientist laws, the one leading parties, plus any of the ecologist laws. Also, I am in no need of political experience, so I can pass all hands dictum. You can see the ecologist law here. And now you know the three of the four roles. Let's repeat, and I show you the last. One. Just that. Well, here we are again. It's the last time because it's the last role of the Academy. This one, well, it's the librarian. I pick the role and let's go and see what it does. Just librarian. Librarian, what grants you is access to the knowledge of the Academy, but I think it's only the library. So it's like Vault Keeper, but instead of having access to all this awesome political stuff, you only granted access to the lower left corner of the Academy setup. Librarian is a consolation prize, somewhat. And basically, you can ask Isiander questions in exchange of dust and in QA answer you. So it's like Galactic Wonders. We basically the price and let's say the Wonders under construction are Endless Research Park, Endless Worlds, Unknown Empire. Well, it's good to know. Or what about the best science production? Who got more fleet, more manpower stock? Civilization, the Emperor, well, yes, I am. And this is about Endless Space 2. This last tab is about Endless Space 2 background and lore. So I won't click here, just I don't want to spoil you if you won't like them or have fun. Just I will click the first one and the caption. Perfection, well, basically the pop perfection does not lend itself to a simple yes or no, what is more perfect, a cell phone equation or a tissue of light, an industrial until all a novelist, all space and time. But if you insist and depart from the more philosophical aspects of the question, the answer is simple. By Horatius' standard, the answer can only be yes. There could be nothing more perfect. So Horatio is perfect. Yes, thank you, sir. And also, this is the ship you can't rent. The Warden of Knowledge, and there's again a carrier. Well, if you ask me, the rented ship, the thing with the rented ship is that you'll have access very early in the game, and having a career at that point, if you can rent it, is always a good thing, even if being only for 20 turns. It's like a single ship fleet. If you ask me, what's the best role? Well, obviously, Brandy isn't. For me, best roles are Grand Admiral or Vault Keeper. Master of Dust is also good if you are playing very diplomatic, but if you want to kill them all, it is again, at least better than Librarian. Grand Admiral is very, very good at the start of the game because it grants you an impressive fleet. The fleet is a good fleet during all the game, but when you have your own carriers, you can beat the Grand Admiral fleet. It's not the same when you have to beat the Grand Admiral fleet with, to say, 7 tier 1 ships. And the one with this academy fleet is Carifer just next to you. It's worse things can happen. But as the game progresses, you can beat this fleet. So at the start of the game, I mostly pick it for the fleet, but also as the main tactic to ensure no other one will get that fleet and attack me. Vault Keeper is good, but it's situational depending on the strategy you are playing, or if you are in need of some law, if you are asked for a quest, or if you just want military laws to kill people. Well, I think it's everything I want to show you about Academy roles, and I finish here this tutorial. There will be a couple more tutorials about the Academy, and some more tutorials about miscellaneous things in this expansion, and the Nakalim faction will have its own series. I think it's 2 tutorials only. But well, also I said I have to rush this one, but you'll have Spanish and Catalan versions in very few days, so you can't wait. Let's see you another time.